In this week's video, we'll look at melted buildings. I don't want to say it's important, or that the video's even good, so I won't. I don't want to promote my coffee, or anything for that matter. As always, I don't know, and I thank you for joining me. Welcome. I want to correct myself. In my last video, I said we seem to be missing 1,000 years of time, when really the truth is we have seemingly had 1,000 years added to our time. And we've discussed this in so many videos. If we look at photographs, maps, coins, we can see a letter I and then the rest of the date. It's something like I-600. We would be told is the year 1600, when in reality the I or the J is clearly a letter, as it's sitting right next to a number. And Sylvie in her New Earth videos way back discussed how the J could have represented Jesus or Jesus. But this is just one anomaly, and it could very well be that they recycle this timeline, loop it over and over, and all these maps and coins could be much older, and in some cases, even newer. If we go back to the Jewish calendar, it's the year 5000-something. If we look at the Mayan calendar, who knows what year it is? What galactic year, I think, as they call it, but that could just be interpretation. I think they call them Bakhtuns. And then the Vedic texts from India also having a giant year, like in the millions, all having different races, species, colors of people, including blue, and a much more detailed history that seems to make more sense, actually. Wow, I don't really know why I'm going Tower of Babel today. Perhaps because I recently talked about it at the end of a video, and of course made a whole video on it a few months back. And I really wanted to let it go. Just a speculation, but it keeps coming back around. As I mentioned in a past video, a channel called Truth Seeker 69 Original had proposed that this may have been the Tower of Babel. And I had also proposed that all mountains could have been Babel-esque back in that video that I made back when. In that video back when, I showed examples of Turkey and Cappadocia, and how these absolutely look like melted buildings. And again, when I say melted, it could be displaced by frequency, or restructured, or superheated and reshaped, whatever you want to call it. We use melted because we have an understanding in this community about what that means, similar to Tartaria. And here I was looking at a site that Jen showed in one of her videos. It's all in Italian. And the first thing that we notice is every single one of these depictions show the eruption in 1779. Every single one. 1779. And this drawing was made in 1880. And in my recent video, they were telling us how this eruption initially occurred in 79 AD. And now we have a 2,000 year difference. Approximately. And this actually makes more sense. Those buildings did not look like buildings from 79 AD. And it didn't look like something that was ravaged by ash and pumice, nor lava. But here what really caught my eye is every picture of Vesuvius shows this kind of outer shell, and then the volcano in the center. Everyone. Outer shell, outer shell, outer shell, inner core. Outer shell, inner core. So this kind of a half circle around a dome, always, as we see here. And then, again, what do we see here with this Tower of Babel? Same thing, a core, outer rim. And I think that these types of structures are what Gary Shunung was talking about in his Old Earth series. These are habitations. Entire cities complete with agriculture and water distribution, as we can see down here in these little tunnels or ducts. And you see how people lived all along the edge of it, within it, and always depicting clouds at the top. But were they clouds? Or were they actually coming from within the structure? Perhaps it was a complete permaculture, maybe like a rainforest in here. Who knows? And in one of these pictures, this one here, we can kind of see this notion. If this was a structure that had collapsed, and here we can see what looks like a river of molten structure. And here, where all these windows would have been, little vents popping out of the sides, just as we see here, if such a thing were to collapse. And again, who knows what was going on inside, if this is just the outside. But to me, so very similar, not unusual, that buildings made of fine quality, most likely concrete, and of course brick, could become so heated and disfigured, and yet still show pockets of preservation, as we see here. Again, this thin veil could be popped out and may only be 1 to 2 inches thick. And all of this was a building. Nobody carved this out. And even under here, we can see more windows as if the structure kept going. But this is a puddle of everything that was stripped off of this building and liquefied. Hence the more reddish color, perhaps much more iron in here, mixed with lime. And these few pictures are from the Tartarian Meltdown channel. We thank you for this. Here's another great example of a structure completely disfigured, and yet just enough preservation to make sense of it. Again, a random chunk of preservation. And if I ever find something like this in the desert, I'll immediately take a hammer to it, right in the center here. And here again, what some would call mountains with carvings in them, actually buildings, turned to rubble, absolute rubble, with small pockets of preservation. And this is Petra in Jordan. And the narrative wants to tell us that primitive people carved all of this out. If one did have the ability to carve, as difficult and impossible as that would be, you would certainly stop at a certain point. You wouldn't scaffold your way up here and carve all this ornamentation and these steps as we see here. No, unbelievable. And you can see how this towered up and looks like the tip of a melted candle now. Excellent examples. And here again, scattered pockets of preservation, hit and miss, as if the heat was coming from below. And eventually so much of the lime gets cooked out that the structure resembles mud. If enough lime is left, we have preservation and parts of the buildings remain intact. Here an example of an area that did not fare so well. A complete wasteland. As the Bible says, the buildings shall melt like wax. And this is your wax. Again, we can see all the lime has been pushed to the surface. But this was once building. Levels. Now collapsed into a pile. Like that day in September. And those two buildings in New York. And even in this absolute wasteland, again, always at the top, we do see a little pocket of survival right up here. A square little building looking like some Anasazi ruins in the deserts of Arizona or even Utah and Colorado, as we can see at the Hovenweep National Monument. Just little pockets of preservation sticking up, and everything below just melted. And very exciting if I stumbled across this. This is always what I'm looking for. Looks like we do have access in here, and we can really imagine the skyline in the background here. And what a crazy world this would have been. So packed. Frankly, I'm Glad we don't live in such a busy world, where all the mountains would have been structures. Probably larger people. And who knows if they were even people. Maybe it was some type of hive or insect creature. But when we look at the remains of Petra, as we just were, they seem very sophisticated and actually in the spirit of the Romanesque architecture that would continue clear into the early 1900s until everything would become cheapened. And this makes me feel like they were more of a humanesque entity, someone who cared about beauty and art. And here a better look at the preservation on top. And a lot of the bombing of the Nevada deserts, even the bombing of Mount Vesuvius, I believe was to get rid of any remains, any little prevailing traces of advanced civilization. Here again, that same survival from the backside. And no doubt, once you see it, you can't unsee it. And lastly, let's just look at some photos that Jen has shared here. These were some pretty rare photos of some buildings atop Mount Vesuvius. We are told that these are brand new buildings, that they built these to promote tourism. Why promote tourism on an active supposed volcano? And it was a big deal back when. Lots of drawings and paintings and depictions of people wanting to go to the top of Vesuvius. Why did they want to go up here? And you know, just now I had an inspiration that perhaps they tell us the gods came from Mount Vesuvius. Even in the Hopi tradition, the Kachina come from a mountaintop, the highest mountaintop in the area. Also said to be a volcano by the academics. And they tell us their gods and everything came from what is now called San Francisco Peak, a beautiful mountain, very Vesuvius-like, presently holding a ski mountain in which I used to frequent. And the mountain is called San Francisco Peak because it's said that on a clear day you could see San Francisco. That's what they say. And yet, if there was any curvature to the earth, that would be impossible. But back to the buildings on Mount Vesuvius that Jen has shared here. Could these be pockets of preservation? Here a little closer, see the tiny people. Does this look like something that was built for tourists atop Mount Vesuvius? Here again, does this look like new construction? Or perhaps a pocket that has survived. Here, if we look at this old picture of the Tower of Babel, one of my favorites, we can see all kinds of buildings on the outside of the tower. And here, this building looks like the one we were just looking at. Here, again, the same archway. And this actually looks like the old road, the old spiraling road. And you see the buildings just right on the path of the road. Here again, some buildings that they told us they built for tourists. They even built a tram to the top. Again, why so important to go look inside this volcano? And a lot of mind-blowing stuff in Jen's video this week. She was even showing some statues depicted in old drawings inside the crater. Cities and drawings. And one might say, oh, a drawing is just a drawing. And here again, you can see smoke coming out of these windows. As if the thing had its own atmosphere inside of it. And all these windows actually acting as vents, letting out the moisture and producing clouds. And here again, a good depiction of that. And of course, I can't say I know. Just my thoughts in a moment. And I thought I would share them with you. And how about a little bonus? Here is the wave. The wave is in Utah and very anomalous. Many in the mud fossil research topic would tell us that this is muscle, tissue, and fiber. And I could see the resemblance, no doubt. And those in the giant tree favorings in our community would say this is part of a giant tree. And I could see that also, seeming like rings. And of course those in the melted building camp would say that this is a melted building. Very fascinating. In our alternative research community, we may bicker amongst each other, but all three are completely outside of the scope of the mainstream, and more specifically geology. Personally, I believe in all three, and I can't say with any certainty exactly what we're looking at here. What I can show you, however, is this picture I took, not a very good one, of what I originally thought was a rock, and it turned out to be a little piece of caulk that had squeezed out of the caulking gun and hardened almost as hard as a rock and gotten dirty. And I sat here and looked at it for a while. You can see Chief sitting here. And I thought how much it reminded me of the wave that we see here. And I must lean towards the melted building camp in this particular example. And yet I am open. If I was to see the form of the body, perhaps I would lean towards Titan mud fossil. And the same goes with the possibility that it could be a tree. Here we can see it from above. Unbelievable. And I'm definitely gonna have to go with melted building on this one. Especially with this top portion that almost looks like some bubbling froth that would have risen to the top and re-solidified. Of course, I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. And here was an interesting share. I forget who shared it now. Here it looks like it's in some other language. Is that German? And the interior is in very good shape of whatever this is. And the outside looks like this. Really reminding me of the Castle Grayskull in He-Man. I always wanted the Castle Grayskull. Here again, some kind of altars in which the statues have been removed. And look at the condition of this brick. Has this been superheated? Seeming to be dripping. And perhaps two different eras of construction. Or has this been refaceted over to hide something? I don't know. And look how it just lines up for miles and miles. Clearly some ley line. Here again, a side view with these massive, either cast blocks or I don't know what. And very anomalous. Something I'd like to read up on, but at this point I'm not even sure what it's called. Super impressive. Are parts of it in ruins, or was it deliberately built that way? Uncertain. And here I finally have begun letting my chickens roam free. They're very happy, eating wild bugs and exotic grains. Here's a share by I don't remember who, and they were showing how even these Peruvian polygonal stones are indeed facades over an older stone or brick, as we can see here, and here a side view. Very interesting, as we discover we live in a world of facade. And I'll just end with this tower in Puerto Rico, in the middle of the rainforest. Very anomalous history, we won't get into it, but completely out of place. And here's a look at parts of this tower. And you can see how this stone also looks kind of faceted or melted and fused. Many would think it's natural. And here again, is this all facade on this castle like tower in Puerto Rico? And this was shared with me in a comment. Here again, a look at this anomalous wall, really looking like a stamped type of concrete facade, but yet so old and weathered. And again, with all the lush beauty around it. And finally, a look at the chaga mushroom. It grows in the side of birch trees. And I believe Quakeys, I think I've seen this fungal burnt-looking growth in the side of Quakeys or aspen trees. Turns out it's not burnt, it's actually a fungus. And you peel this away and you have a beautiful orange mass of mycelium or mushroom. And this is super, 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 super healing, beneficial for just about everything. And again, in the health community, it's called chaga. And I look forward to going out and harvesting some. And I guess that's perfectly it. Thanks so much for joining me today. Do have a blessed day. I love you all, and I'll see you next week.